Kanye should stop making music. He should just go make some more shoes.
I don't think you understand Kanye West. Like, that's why I don't even know if I can take your opinion right now.
Drake said you fell off. You fell off. The music sucks.
I don't know if you even know what we're talking about. We're talking about Kanye.
There's only two artists that get consistently billions of streams year after year, and it's not Kanye.
Kanye doesn't just drop music. He's not just dropping music. He produces. He f***ing raps. He's a designer. He runs businesses.
If your metro don't trust you, I'm gonna show you.
What's good, everybody? If you clicked on this video, you're probably interested in the new Kanye West Vultures 1 album review by us. But before we get into it, I just want to give some overarching stats of the project. It broke a ton of records, but I just want to name a few. So this is the first independent number one album of the decade, went number one in 110 plus countries, the 11th biggest Spotify opening week, 20 million plus in Yeezy merch sold, and Ty Dolla $ign's first number one album. And in this show, we're going to go over what we liked, what we didn't like, the overall vibe of the projects. Joshua will probably give some of his favorite songs. But Joshua, what was the overall vibe of the project? What did you take from it? And did you enjoy it?
This has been Kanye's best project since Life of Pablo. This actually gave me very much College Dropout vibes. And there was a connection. And a lot of people think that Kanye actually held the album so the dates lined up for exactly 10 years later from College Dropout. So I think that there's a lot of correlation between that album and this album. In College Dropout, there's just a ton of like mashups. And Ye does that. That's kind of like his thing. But I thought this album had a ton of different mashups. Like every song could have almost been like its own like album style. And he did a very good job of capturing what's now and how social kind of drives a lot of songs. I've already kind of like seen some of his music videos he's dropped, and it looks very good. Like the one for Culture is Vultures is fantastic. The one for Culture is great. It's going to be iconic. Ye's always known for his great music videos. So I'm sure a lot of these songs are going to have very captivating music videos. I thought it was a great album. I thought it was literally his best album he's had in years. And you know, the one thing I will say, and I said this to Zachary, Kanye seems happy on this album. It seems like he's making music that makes him happy, and it showed. And I think that's why it's the best album he's had in a fucking decade almost, because of his happiness. And I respect the fuck out of that.
I respect that Kanye's happy. I hope he's happy. I'm happy for him. I'm going to take the complete other side than Joshua. I thought the project was awful. Kanye should stop making music. He should just go make some more shoes, build some more businesses. I did not enjoy the project. There was one song that I liked, Problematic.
Couldn't
at the
be
very
farther
end.
From the truth.
No. Kanye, listen. Drake said you fell off. You fell off. The music sucks. Sucks. And this is my biggest thing. If it wasn't for Ty Dolla $ign, I might have turned it off after the fourth song. Ty Dolla $ign put the team on his back and carried it. But it also is the overarching theory of Ty Dolla $ign. He's a great feature, and he just happens to be featured throughout the album, which is what makes Kanye great, knowing that Ty Dolla $ign would have worked perfect with the project. That's where Kanye's great. I'm not taking away
with so much hate today. This guy woke up with so much hate.
I'm not taking away from what Kanye's done for music and the way he produces and the way he thinks. I have a lot of admiration. I respect Kanye for a lot of reasons. This project is not good. Drake said you fell off. You fell off. Just go do something else. I did not enjoy it at all.
Drake would like this album. And Drake would be a hater if he didn't like this album. This is a good album. Yes, it is. And Drake's a Ty Dolla $ign guy. Like, he loves Ty Dolla $ign. So let's all be honest with ourselves. One, Ty Dolla $ign is an absolute hit maker. He is great on a feature. Anytime I see a Ty Dolla $ign feature, you know it's going to be a hit. One. Two, Kanye killed this album. Like, Drake would agree Kanye killed this album. I bet you there's a ton of different people on this, so it's like hard to be like it was just a Ye album. Like all of Kanye's like recent albums, they're a conglomerate of a lot of different artists, producers that help make this vision, which I respect. But this is a fantastic album. Like I said, he sold 148,000 units in the first week. And I know you say first week numbers are...
It doesn't matter.
It does, but it will matter because this is Kanye's best album in a decade.
And I want to reiterate. First week sales do matter for the hype of the project, but it doesn't matter for big artists like Drake and Kanye.
Because there's tons of marketing behind it.
As soon as they drop it, it automatically goes platinum. It like people are already downloaded. People have the automatic download. So it doesn't matter. So my biggest thing with this is in 4 months, are people still listening to this project?
Yes. Yes.
I don't think so.
Yes. You are so, you couldn't be more wrong.
I'm going to give it a courtesy listen, but
no, you couldn't be more wrong. The first five songs of the album, first of all, are all hits. All hits.
I wanted to turn it off after the first five.
No, because you're not listening. Like, you want to listen to your style shit. You, like, I love Rod Wave, but like, you're the melodic rap, that's all you want. And if it's not that, you're like, nah, I don't know if I like it.
I like Drake. He doesn't just do melodic.
Pretty much. Drake can do it all, though. And that's the difference. Drake does it all at a high level. Kanye's trying to bring you through. Like, Kanye's trying to paint you a picture. Like, that's how I look at a lot of these. Like, some of the songs, it's like he's building a piece. Like, that could be its own, like, short film. That's not how you're looking at it. You're looking at it as like, is this poppy? Is it? No. It's like, no, to me, that was a masterpiece and it just went over your head. And that's one thing. A lot of albums I really truly liked, I can be honest with myself. A lot of albums I truly loved the most, I didn't care for the first couple listens.
I'm going to give it a courtesy listen because it's Kanye West and we're sitting here talking about it. No. But off the first listen, terrible. Terrible.
No, you should definitely give it. You should give it 10 listens and then tell me what you think about it. I think a lot of it went over your head. It went over your head.
Listen, Kanye's happy and he's not dealing with that pain anymore to make good music.
No, he has great. Like, a lot of the things are about making a good song and like what people would want to use. Like, I heard a lot of those sounds into like, if you just randomly clicked on this song, you'd be like, huh, out of context, you might not like the song. But I think when you listen to the context of like, what is he trying to make of this? Like, when you listen to the album full through, top to bottom, you're going to realize that there's a story. He's bringing you through the roller coaster. We talk about this all the time. Music, an album is supposed to take you through a roller coaster of emotions, things. Well, Kanye just brought you on the fucking Millennium Force, for all you Cedar Point people, if you don't know what the fuck that is, sorry. But like, he brought you on the best ride and you don't even care. Like, Drake put you on a great ride, obviously. Rod Wave, obviously. Kanye put you on a different emotion. It's not so like one thing. Kanye's going to bring out 100 different emotions because he's feeling 100 different things every second. You have to understand.
I had this thought Kanye.
It's a different thing.
Kanye and Kendrick are like very similar.
Why?
They're just in their own lane of music. And they do their own thing, goes over people's head. It's a certain people that love Kendrick or love Kanye. And I just think that they kind of play the same game, but it goes into my overarching theory. So all these people say I don't even want to hate on Kanye because Kanye does stream a lot better than Kendrick does, of course. But it's like all these people are like, oh, I love Kanye. I love Kendrick. But then at the end of the year, like the streams don't add up. You know, the listens don't add up. The rewards don't add up.
Kanye,
and then it's just like all these people.
Bro,
just,
Kanye's
on,
been dropping
on,
Jesus
on,
albums.
On,
that's why.
Hold on.
What are you talking
about?
Hold on.
I think the Jesus album helped him,
no,
actually.
No, you're so wrong. I couldn't be further from the truth.
Bro, that thing
Zachary.
Streamed like crazy.
Dude, Zachary, it's like his 10th most streamed album. Go look at the charts, bro. Like his early. Dude, Zachary, I don't think you understand Kanye West. Like, that's why I don't even know if I can take your opinion right now. He outstreamed 50 Cent at the height of 50 Cent. Like, who? No one did that. Like, I don't think you understand how big 50 Cent was. Like, you're not understood. Like, put some respect on Kanye's name.
I'm putting respect on
his
name.
No, you're not. You're like, oh, this guy needs to stop doing music and go to shoes. One, he's done what no artist has ever done, making music. And he's, I should say producer. Like, he was a fucking producer who turned one of the biggest rappers / producers ever. Like,
I agree. And I give him
that's,
that.
And
I give him that.
Again, I love Drake. Like, he's my favorite artist of all time. But Drake did it backwards. He was the rapper. And now at the end of his career, like most rappers do, they go, I want to be the producer. Kanye was like, I want to be a producer. And we can all look at, you know, KJ, if you want to look back at that interview. KJ, what you got going on, man? He even talks about how people put you in a box. You are just this thing. He broke out of it in a time where this wasn't fucking streaming numbers. Like, people had to go out and buy his album. I just watched a video today. Curtis, the album that 50 Cent lost to Graduation to, all right? That album, 50 Cent put $10 million behind. $10 million. Kanye had nothing at that time. He was a fucking producer, had no money. Everyone thought he was a joke. And he outstreamed a guy who was at the top of his game, the Drake-level guy. And
don't compare 50 Cent to Drake.
Oh,
please.
My God, dude. Oh, no. My God. Dude, Zachary doesn't even know history of hip-hop. Like, you don't know history of hip-hop.
50 Cent was popping back
oh
then.
My, but you
had
it's
one
a different,
project.
Oh, my. One project? Are you fucking
one
stupid?
One project.
Dude, you are
don't compare
delusional.
Drake when Drake can
delusional.
Put out hits after hits.
It's a different time, Zachary. 50 Cent was selling 200,000 albums in a week. That's a fucking CD, Zachary. People had to go out and buy the CD. Yes, Drake does numbers, and I'm not taking... I love Drake. Again, favorite artist of all time. I don't want to reiterate that enough. It is a lot easier for Drake to sell a fucking album today. For years, all of Drake's massive album sales, and again, Drake fan, love you to death, Drake, if you ever see this. He was selling bundles, and that's why Tekashi 6ix9ine, that's why they changed after Tekashi, because Tekashi got number one. Because he was selling bundles. All these artists, these big artists, were just selling bundles, which equal album sales. And yes, Drake can do it all because he can act, he can sing, he can rap. These are people, you're talking about rappers. Rappers.
I actually think it's harder to have a number one album these days than it was back in the day.
I disagree because there's they have
so
to put
no,
you
no, 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 no. Let's talk about the internet.
Yes, let's talk about the internet.
The decentralization of the internet. There's so many more artists. There's so many more people you can listen to.
If you were not a mainstream artist, you could not even get a CD out to then sell a CD to then have a first week. That's what I'm saying. It's so much harder back in the day because right now, Zachary, we could be like the real Oshow is coming out with a rap group. And we could drop a CD today, an album today. And yes, it might not get any sales.
That's why it's harder. But that's why it's harder to do it now.
But in 1990, we couldn't even do that. We couldn't get a studio time. We couldn't get a mic. You couldn't get nothing. Like, you had no access unless we had thousands and thousands of dollars. Today, we could fucking have a cool sound, build it on SoundCloud over years. And on our first album release in 5 years from now, we could actually make a killing. Because look at Rod Wave. Rod Wave doesn't have all this big marketing push. He sold out fucking 2 years in a row of stadiums, basketball stadiums, had number one albums. He doesn't have this huge machine behind him. Exactly. So it's easier today than it was in the fucking 90s.
Just one of the best ever.
Exactly. But it's
because cream rises at the top.
But you can't consider what you're saying, Rod Wave, a hip hop artist, though. Rod Wave isn't a hip, like, he doesn't just rap.
He's a musician.
Exactly. So, but
that's how I classify.
But
Drake,
that's why
as
you
well.
Can't take away. You can't take away a guy like 50 Cent who was not singing on the beat. He was true to true rap.
Yeah.
That's true rap. That's not marketable to everyone. And he
I
was selling.
I completely agree.
So that's why you can't compare it to like old Drake or easier now than like. I disagree. It is more saturated now. You could argue that it's more saturated.
I think it's 100%.
I disagree. I completely disagree.
So much more out there.
100%. There's so much more out there, but it's way easier. And I think. Because of there's easy accessible, like now there's AI. Now, and I could technically have a fucking Drake feature today and put it on a song. Yeah, it might get copywritten or it might not. Who knows? Drake might just fuck with it and be like, yeah.
I truly think it's harder. And I'm not taking away from 50 Cent. Big fan of 50 Cent. The way he obviously, from a rap standpoint, and then did Get Rich or Die Trying, the movie, and then Eminem almost spun off it and did the same thing. Brilliant, genius. 50 Cent is, once again, brilliant businessman and has spun off a great career. What I'm trying to say is back in the day, if you got a song on the radio, you then could sell a tour, all these albums, where now radio is irrelevant. Everybody has every song, every single person, let me talk, every single person at their fingertips. It is so much harder to go number one and get consistent streams now because there's so much to listen to. People are going on tours after blowing up on TikTok now. They're going on world tours, Joshua.
I'm just saying, Zachary, I think it's...
With 40,000 followers.
You're comparing potatoes to fucking an apple, and I think that it's
maybe
completely different. And I think that there's just no comparison. You're not going to compare these different eras. I would argue there's a lot less people doing it.
That's fine. If you don't want to compare eras, saturated. Then don't put 50 Cent and Drake in the same category,
please. But
that's where this all started.
But like, Zach, no, it's not where it all started. I compared it to Drake. I'm sorry, I compared it to Kanye and 50 Cent, and I don't want to get the fucking wheels off here.
You definitely said Drake and 50 Cent.
Zachary, rewind the fucking tape. Who was at the top of his game, the Drake-level guy, and...
Don't compare 50 Cent to Drake.
Oh, my God, dude. I said 50 Cent got beat up by Kanye West after spending $10 million, and then we brought Drake into the mix because you said, oh, well, Drake. And I was like, no. We're not comparing Drake to this. Drake's a whole different other
animal.
Wow,
the tape is going to be crazy on this
one. The tape is
going to
be crazy.
Because you mentioned Drake and 50 Cent first.
Stop.
You try to compare them both.
Exactly.
You did.
I was comparing Kanye because that's what we're talking about today.
Yes.
I don't know if you even know what we're talking about.
Yes.
We're talking about Kanye And then
Kanye's irrelevant at this point. The album sucked. We're on to better things.
And I want to get not too far off, because someone actually clicked on this for the Kanye album. I want to actually talk about the Kanye album. But yes, we were talking about how Kanye beat 50 Cent. And after 50 Cent spent $10 million to market Curtis, that was what I was talking about.
Yes.
And I was talking about the College Dropout.
Yes.
That's what I was talking about.
You mentioned Drake and 50 Cent together.
Oh my God, Jesus Christ.
You're going to edit this and be like, you know what, Zachary was right, and I better get an apology.
No.
That's all I want is an apology.
I won't give you an apology, because that's not what happened.
And I'll forgive you.
That's not what happened. Zachary's delusional. He actually needs to check himself today. So let's get back to the Kanye album, because I do want to talk about a couple things. One, I want to talk about what my favorite songs were.
Do your favorite songs briefly, and then let's go into like your top three Kanye songs ever.
Ever. I don't know if I'm prepared to talk about.
Yes, you are. No, let's not. Go. Do your top three and let's go.
I don't think I'm prepared to talk about it, the best ever of Kanye. Off the Vultures album, my top songs in no particular order were Keys to My Life, Back to Me, Beg for Forgiveness. It was also the same one you had as well.
Problematic.
I like
that. Was the only one I liked.
No, Problematic was a great one as well. And I also wanted to take away from the song Talking, which had a Northwest feature. I thought he killed it. I don't know if that's off the backs of, again, we speak about Drake. Was it because Adonis and Drake?
He copied Drake.
Yeah, and there was a little stigma around our guy Suspense. If you don't know, now you know that guy. If Suspense talked about how Kanye actually fudged the numbers when this song got released because he wanted it to beat Adonis's song, I don't know if that's true. I don't know if that's
true.
Actually, it probably is true.
Because Kanye can't sell like Drake.
But it doesn't. You could argue that Drake can't sell like Kanye too. Drake has never sold billions of dollars worth of stuff.
He's so, never really pushed it.
It doesn't matter. Nocta? Grow up. Come on. And so let's be honest with ourselves. And again, I'm not a Drake hater. I fucking love Drake. I just want to check Zachary, because Zachary's on his knees fucking slurping up Drake right now. So I have to check him a little bit. And then
there's only two artists that get consistently billions of streams year after year. Bro, and it's not Kanye.
Kanye doesn't just drop music. He's not just dropping music. He produces. He fucking raps. He's a designer. He runs businesses.
I agree.
Zachary, you're talking about totally different things. Like, It's what are we even speaking about? You're like, oh, he doesn't just do music. No shit, he doesn't just do music.
I agree.
He literally, Kanye had an interview and he talked about it. He's like, I lose like $800 million a year when I decide to do music.
Yes.
So what are you talking about? Okay.
I saw that. Whatever. He shouldn't do that. He should just stick to the business part. We appreciate you tuning in and listening to us bicker back and forth about the Kanye project. If you made it this far, drop a like, leave a comment, subscribe, share, and roast Joshua in the comments for his terrible opinion on Kanye and comparing Drake. Like, it just is out of this world. But we appreciate you listening. Till next time. About to get all this dough. Me and no fuck niggas know. I swear to God, we the ghosts. This ain't the story they told. Man, if you know, then you know. I never had to tell my dogs when we on roof for greatness.